I'm Father Aloysius Mowe, and I'm the International Director for Advocacy and Communications with the Jesuit Refugee Service based here in Rome. We are the work of the Society of Jesus that provides services, that accompanies refugees, and that advocates for their cause. World Refugee Day is being celebrated this year on Wednesday, the 20th of June. And this is a time for us to reflect again on the world's response to refugees. We often speak of a refugee crisis, and Pope Francis has always reminded us that we should not speak of a refugee crisis, but a crisis of solidarity. World Refugee Day this year reminds us of the record number of refugees in the world today, and of the need for greater solidarity, especially in the global north, in the richest countries of the world, in terms of welcoming refugees, of protecting them, of promoting their needs and their cause, and of integrating them into our communities. These four verbs of welcome, protect, promote, and integrate are verbs that Pope Francis has told us again and again we should use when we speak of refugees and we speak of our response to them, which is a response based on gospel values that we should welcome, feed, protect, visit, show complete solidarity with those who are most in need. And who are more in need than the refugees who today, as we have seen, even in Italy in the last few weeks, people are being turned away by richer countries. Countries that have the resources and the ability to welcome and to protect are saying, we do not want to do this. Pope Francis and his message of welcome, I think this World Refugee Day reminds us that especially the most vulnerable among refugees, children, are people who should be dearest to our heart and close to our heart. We should welcome them, protect them, promote and integrate them as concrete ways to live the gospel today. And this week, in particular for GRS and for our partners Interculturas, we want to say to the world that the education of refugees, refugee children, this education is what will give them hope for the future, but it also builds on hope and peace for the countries that welcome them. Children bring potential and capacity with them. We should welcome them not because they are a burden, but because they bring the gift of themselves and the gift of newness and creativity and potential, which we can all benefit from as one common human family.